Now that we saw what this course offers for you, and right before we dive into the course services, in this lecture I want to highlight how you get the most out of the course. Of course you should watch the videos, and feel free to watch a video more than once if something is unclear, or if you proceeded and later see that something you thought that was clear isn't clear. Also feel free to play around with that playback speed. You can adjust it on the Udemy video player, and that's a great tool for you if I'm going too fast or slow for your individual pace. Now besides watching the videos, also code along or build along. Build the APIs I'm showing you, write the Lambda code I'm showing you. Keep in mind, of course, to check the pricing if you're experimenting a lot, but in general, everything I show in this course will be well within the free tier, so there is room for experimentation. And by building along, you really learn a lot more than by just watching the videos. Now, occasionally when building along, you might get stuck or find an error. For cases like these, I provide some source materials, some code attached to various lectures. For example, I regularly attach API snapshots, Swagger definition files, which are simply text files you can use when you create a new API in API Gateway. You can import them to replicate my API, and I will show this or mention this throughout this course. The same for Lambda. I do provide my source code, and this is a great resource for you to compare your solution to mine. If you still are stuck or you have some other question related to course lectures, feel free to ask them. Ask in the Q&A section, but please, more important than asking, also answer. Answer the questions of other students. This is how you really learn the most. By answering, you are really challenged to think about it, and you can't do anything wrong here. If your answer is not 100% correct, then someone else is going to tell you, and that's it, and you'll learn again. So making mistakes actually is the best way of learning, and I can only encourage you to take that chance and also answer in the Q&A section. And with that, let's move on and let's finally dive into the core services we'll need in this course.